I want to introduce you to a concept that'll likely revolutionize the way you do what you do if you're trained to build muscle. So I'm just going to talk and you can kind of just follow along with the board here. Now, most people don't know how to train, and even those who believe they know how to train generally just know how to go to the gym and do a bunch of different exercises. This is not training. So what is training in its simplest form, if we were to break it down? It's problem solving. You identify a problem, you design a strategy to solve that problem, then you go to the gym until it's solved. Once it's solved, you move on to the next problem and you revamp your strategy accordingly. Now, if you're there to build muscle, the formula is very simple. Recruit plus fatigue minus overwork. But what does that actually look like? Well, it's going to vary from person to person, but what you're going to need is you're going to need tools, and you're going to need to do some work with those tools. Now, the tools you use and the way you use them should be based on the problem that you're trying to solve. Now, when you do a repetition, two things happen: potentiation and fatigue. Potentiation basically means the nervous system making an immediate adjustment to what you're doing, and in an attempt to reduce the demand being placed on the body for survival purposes, it more efficiently recruits the muscles on your body, so it makes things easier. It increases performance. Fatigue decreases performance. So this is why the second rep is easier than the first one, or the second set will be easier than the first one, as long as the first one didn't create too much fatigue. So what happens is recruitment promotes fatigue, and then fatigue affects recruitment. You ever notice if you do the same exercise twice in a workout, maybe once at the beginning and once at the end, the second time you do it, it feels entirely different? Why would that be if it's the same muscles responsible for producing force to perform the same direction of effort? It's because fatigue affects recruitment. So if muscle fibers are fatigued, the brain has to recruit other muscle fibers or other muscles entirely, and that is why it feels different. So the point I'm trying to illustrate here is that you can use the same tool to promote various responses based on how you use the tool and how you sequence the work that you're doing. Now, every tool that you include into your strategy, there should be a fucking reason for that. What is the purpose of using this tool? Is it to recruit, to fatigue, or to facilitate? Now, most tools are multifaceted in that you can modify the way you use them to promote various responses. However, if you're not feeling the right muscle working when you're doing a certain exercise, you might want to rethink the way you're doing what you do. You can use other tools to facilitate the effectiveness of that tool. So an example would be if you're doing a bench press for the chest and you're not feeling it in the chest, why are you going to continue to do the rest of your sets instead of doing something else like a fly that could increase the demand on the chest and increase your capacity to recruit it, and then go back to the bench press and thus get a greater return on investment and get more from doing that exercise? But people don't do this. People have their training in place before they go to the gym, and the likeliness of your workout being exactly what you need on any given day is slim to none. Your body's going to respond differently based on the focus, intensity, concentration, and effort that goes into your work. It's impossible to forecast how you're going to respond. So what most people do, it looks like this. If they want to build muscle, they want to recruit and fatigue. They'll do exercise A, 4 to 5 sets of 6. Exercise B, 4 by 8. C, 3 by 10 to 12. D, 3 by 15 to 20. What is the likeliness that you got everything you could have out of each of those exercises in that order? This isn't to suggest that you can't get results doing this, because this is how almost 100% of the population trains, and a lot of people still get results. But if you want the best results, you gotta learn to pay attention to the feedback that your body is giving you and make the appropriate course correction as you go. When I say appropriate course correction, think of a homing missile that got launched and its target is an airplane. The homing missile has to account for the elements, the wind, the weather, and the fact that the fucking airplane is going like 1,000 miles an hour. It is not a fixed target. And if it doesn't make the appropriate course correction, it's not going to hit its target. This is how you need to address your training. So you don't actually need to know what you're going to do before you go to the gym. You have a general idea of what you're going to train and why you're going to do it. Train a certain muscle with the intent to recruit and fatigue it. What are you going to do? Well, it's going to vary based on how your body responds to the work that you're doing. So you might not be able to say beforehand what you're going to do, but you might be able to look back after and say, this is what I did. So the individual who understands this, their workout might look like this, but they wouldn't have been able to tell you this before the workout. So it might look something like this. They did an exercise for 20 reps. The purpose was to facilitate. Then they moved on to their bread and butter exercise with the purpose of recruiting. They did a set of 5. It felt good. They did another set of 5. That didn't feel good. They went back to exercise A, maybe did a 30-second isometric with the purpose of increasing the capacity to recruit so they get more from the other exercise that they're doing. They go back to it, more weight, do a set of 3. Felt good, another set of 3. Understanding that you can use the same tool to promote various responses, lighten the load, do a set of 20 with the exact same exercise. Only now your focus is to fatigue because you've already recruited. Move on to the next exercise. Do a set of 20 in an attempt to fatigue the muscles that you're training. Felt good, another set of 20. Didn't feel so good, went back to the exercise that they used to facilitate, did a set of 15, and then finished with one more set of 15 with the third exercise they included. Move on to the fourth exercise, bang out 40 reps. The purpose is to fatigue. So it doesn't matter how you get them. You could get 40 at once. Who knows how this person got it on this day? Maybe they got to 20, waited 10 seconds, did another 10, waited 10 seconds, did another 10. There's their 40. Went back to the bread and butter exercise because they understood there's a reason why they included it in their strategy, and they're gonna get more out of it by doing it at the end because fatigue affects recruitment. Did a set of 10, felt good, did another set of 10, finished up with the last exercise they included and did a set of 30. Now the difference here is this person made the appropriate course correction as they went, and they got more out of every single exercise that they included into their strategy. In both cases, it's four exercises. In both cases, it's the exact same amount of sets, but the difference is in the way you do what you do. I always talk about it's the way you do what you do that will determine most the return you get on your investment of time and effort. Now some people say, well, how do you measure progress here? And the answer to that is this. Not everything that can be measured matters, and not everything that matters can be measured. When you learn how to do this, and you learn how to work within a framework and promote the response that you're there to get and make the appropriate course correction as you go, is when you can do whatever the fuck you want. You have the free will to do it. And because of this, you'll actually enjoy what you're doing more. And because you enjoy it more, you're going to work harder and you're going to promote a greater return on investment. The people that focus on the minor details, like specifics and how to quantify progression, are generally the ones that get the least results. It's about imposing a fucking demand, and this is what training is. I don't expect everybody to get it right now, but when you do, you'll thank me later.